They starts with a cowboy, ends with a wine taste. Never getting ready, never on time for anything. She gets that come-get-me look in her eye. Well, it kind of scares me the way that she drives me wild. She drives me wild. Beautiful, crazy, she can't help but me.
Of all the relationships known among people, the most precious and perfect of all is that of husband and wife. It is therefore fitting that we should be gathered here in the sight of God to witness the vows of this man and this woman, and by our presence, and especially by our prayers, to bless their union. Who gives this woman to be the bride of this man?
The mother and I.
This is the second time that Russ and I have found ourselves standing up here together. The first was 27 years ago this month, when he and I, where he stood, where Harry was standing just a few moments ago. He was presenting Stephanie to me to be my wife. I was honored when Russ and Tina asked me to be a part of their special day. I want to take just a moment to wish the two of them the same amount of love, joy, and happiness that Steffi and I have found over our last 27 years together. Now Megan is going to come and offer a blessing over the wedding.
So they do what's called
closer.
So I'm going to do the priestly prayer over the wedding groom. Baraka Adonai Yeshemora Ya'er Adonai Hana Alacha Yichaneka Isa Adonai Hana Alacha Yasin Alacha Shalom.
I will do a quick poem as well.
This is a poem by Rabbi Rumi. May these vows and this marriage be blessed. May it be sweet milk, this marriage like wine in Hava. May this marriage offer fruit and shade like the date palm. May this marriage be full of laughter, our every day a day in paradise. May this marriage be a sign of compassion, a seal of happiness here and hereafter. May this marriage have a fair face and a good name, an omen as welcomes the moon in a clear blue sky. I am out of words to describe how spirit mingles this marriage.
Now, Russ and Tina have prepared their own vows. So we all please join hands, face each other, and express your vows of love and devotion.
If I can get through this. The presence of God, and these are our family and friends. Thank you. Be my wife. Promising with divine assistance. Down to you, your loving and faithful husband. As long as you both shall live. And by my side, to the best and the worst, you have loved all that I am. It's taken all these years to find someone who loves more than themselves. There you are, standing behind me, supporting me in my toughest times. All I had to do was turn around and recognize you as my soulmate, my hero, of the love of my life. I promise to love you and hold you and grow very, very old into you.
They say you should never tell a crush how you feel. Why scare them away? The secret is best to conceal. I didn't say it out loud. It was hidden in simple details. As time passes, I cheered you on, knowing I'd stay your number one fan no matter what happens. So I waited because I knew you were the one for me. You bring butterflies, nerves, a lot of deep breaths. But I always feel comfortable around you because you remember the little details that everybody else forgets. You go out of your way, like when you give me coffee in the morning. I swear you didn't mind. The way you actually laugh out loud at the TV, the little jokes you make, always teasing. A notes app I've so carefully tucked away. I've saved all the details you've mentioned. I remember all these things that you say. You're one of a kind, and I'm done dragging around the secret that I carried. I love you. You are the man I'm going to marry.
Now, Aaron will come for a special reading.
This is a reading that Russ gave for me.
Closer.
Read. Everybody hear me now?
Yes.
Treat yourselves and each other with respect and remind yourselves often of what brought you together. Give the highest priority to the tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that your connection deserves. When frustration, difficulties, and fear assail your relationship, as they threaten all relationships at one time or another, remember to focus on what is right between you, not only the part what seems wrong. In this way, you can ride out the storms when clouds hide the face of the sun in your lives, remembering that even if you lose sight of it for a moment, the sun is still there. And if each of you takes responsibility for the quality of your life together, it will be marked by abundance and delight. Now you'll feel no rain, for each of you will be sheltered for the other. Now you'll feel no cold, for each of you will be warmed to the other. Now there'll be no loneliness, for each of you will be companions to the other. Now you are two persons, but there's only one life before you. May beauty surround you both in the journey ahead through all the years. May happiness be your companion, and your days together be good and long upon the earth.
Having this unfailing love in your hearts, you have chosen to exchange the rings as a sign and seal of the vow you are making today. May I have the rings? Though small in size, these rings are very large in significance. Made of precious metal, they remind us that love is not cheap nor common. Indeed, love may cost us dearly. Made in a circle, their design tells us that love must never come to an end. We must keep it continuous. As you wear these rings, whether together or apart, may they be constant reminders of these glad promises you are making today. Will you take this ring and place it on Tina's left hand and repeat after me? Tina, with this ring, I be wed. I be wed. I choose you to be my wife.
Choose you to be my wife.
And pledge my love.
Pledge my love.
To be your faithful and loving husband.
Faithful, loving husband.
Tina? You take this ring and place it on Russ's left hand and repeat after me. Russ, with this ring, I be wed.
Russ, with this ring, I be wed.
I choose you to be my husband.
I choose you to be my husband.
And pledge my love.
And pledge my love.
To be your faithful and loving wife.
To be your faithful and loving wife.
You have come before us and before God and have expressed your desire to be husband and wife. You have shown your love and affection by joining hands, have made promises of faith and devotion, each to one another, and you have sealed these promises by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore pronounce you husband and wife. Russ, you may kiss the bride. All right, ladies and gentlemen, friends and family, I have the privilege to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Chaby.